With TU12 right around the corner, we will get a lot of new additions. New gear, new brand set, new gear set, new weapons, you name it. Let's have a look, shall we? Are you ready? Let's go! What up, YouTube? Welcome to another Division 2 video. Thanks for clicking my content. Really appreciate you watching it. If you like my content and want to help the channel out, don't forget to smash that like button. And today we're gonna talk about all the new gear, the brand set, the gear set, and of course the named items that are introduced with TU12. I'm on the PTS right now, the test server for TU12 that will drop around mid-December probably. And I'm gonna show you everything they have to offer. Of course, yesterday talking about the new exotics, the three new exotics coming out, and then of course creating our own god rolls with the new optimization station. So let's dive in and start with the new brand set. So I equipped it, and the new brand set is called Empress International. The first piece will give you 10% skill health, 10% skill damage for the second piece, and if you wear three pieces, it will give you 10% skill efficiency. And then of course we have the named items with it. It comes as the Caesar's Guard Vest, and that will handle the perfectly skilled, so the skills have a 30% chance to reset skill cooldowns instead of that 25% that you normally have. And then of course we have a named backpack as well, also from Empress International, and this will give us the battery pack with the perfectly calculated on there, and that's 15% instead of that 10%. But guys, this could be a very nice addition to the game, especially with all the skill builds are getting a big boost. They're getting a lot of love in TU12. And even the skill DPS builds could work with the Empress International, because we're getting skill health, we're getting skill damage, but we're getting more than that 10%. And why? If you wear the three piece, you will get skill efficiency. And skill efficiency was one of the new things added with TU10. And this will give you multiple things on the skill side of things. So you will get 10% skill damage, 10% skill health. So the first two already become 20% skill damage and 20% skill health. And then of course we will have skill duration, skill repair, some status effect, and let me quickly look, I think that's probably it. Those are the five things you will get with skill efficiency. So this brand set will give you that 20% skill health and a 20% skill damage only wearing a three piece, because we are of course getting that skill efficiency. So this could be a very nice addition, and especially rolling again that skill damage on there with the crit, for example, you can boost your skill damage quite a lot, especially with the skill efficiency as the third brand set bonus. So this could be quite something, guys. I don't know, especially about calculated, you know, I don't like to use that talent that much, and the same for the perfectly skilled. Of course it's nice with explosive builds, if you use for example your mine build, throw mines all over the place. If you take out an enemy, it has 30% chance to give it back. But in my opinion, go for damage, for example for glass cannon, giving you that 25 or even 30% extra damage. And yes, this will work for every kind of damage, not only your weapon damage, for everything. So in my opinion, it's more worth it to go with attacking kind of talent like glass cannon than go for the perfectly skilled. But yeah, that's my opinion. So let's head over to the new gear set, guys. Yes, we will get a new gear set as well, and that is the Rigger gear set. I switch it over. Don't worry, this is not a straight build. This is just something to put together to show you what the rigger gear set will do. So the two pieces will give you that 15% skill haste, the three pieces will give you that 15% skill duration, and then with the four pieces, tent and befriend will be activated. Interacting with your deployed skills grant the skills 25% skill damage for 10 seconds, and this buff cannot be refreshed. Interacting includes using or deploying the skill, changing the skill's target, and of course healing the skill. So if you are next to it, you pop your cam launcher for yourself and for your skill, you will boost that skill to that 25% skill damage for, of course, 10 seconds. So let's head over to the shooting range and let me quickly show how this works. And there we are, guys, at the shooting range, and let's test out this rigger gear set. And it's not about how high my damage numbers will be, but only between the difference if 10 and beyond is activated or not, because I'm not min-maxed at PC. Most of my characters are on PS4 or, of course, future PS5. So let's test it out. Named shooting range on heroic. Let's set down our turret and see what kind of damage it does. We're setting it down so you see there's an activation. 71.6k is the damage that our turret does now. Activation goes away, so the tent and beyond is not active anymore, and we're shooting for 63.7. But if we now switch over to an other enemy, switching over to him and then switching back, you will see that the tent and beyond is activated again and switching over to that 71.6 again. So this is the way that you can do it. You can switch from different kind of enemies. I tried it with healing it, but it should work. But as you can see, it says that the boost is active, but the damage numbers do not raise. But I'm sure that they will fix that when the PTS is over. This is only wave one. So don't forget, guys, everything is subject to change. And yeah, they should change this gear set because, in my opinion, it's a bit underperforming. If you want to go for a full gear set, you're only having one attribute, then it needs to be powerful, or at least powerful enough to come close to the builds that we rock now with the skill damage with the drone and turret combination. So in my opinion, the rigger gear set could be a lot better. So then, of course, we have some more named items, and those are the two named guns. We will have the test subject, the new AR, and this is just the AR that we know from the capacitator. This is the new AR coming to the game, and we have the normal version as well, and it's the PDR. So you can see exactly the same. This is maxed out as well, but of course then the talent, we can choose whatever we like because the named one has perfectly in sync on there. And this is one of the guns that probably is gonna be loved by the whole community because the perfectly in sync does a lot for you. But guys, there is a big but. It's only 700 RPM. It has a mag of 30. And we can only put on 3 attachments. So it isn't that great. It shoots too slow, in my opinion. There are a lot more ARs that will shoot a lot faster, so bursting out a lot more damage, like the FAMAS or even the M4 hitting for that 850 RPM, and then just go for the normal in sync instead of the perfectly in sync. Still, the perfectly in sync will give you, of course, a lot more damage output, but over time, the FAMAS or even the M4 will do a lot more damage. And that's why I think this could be something, but the mag size or the RPM needs to change. It needs to be higher, or then the damage, the base damage needs to be higher, because if I'm not mistaken, the base damage is around 40k. Let's see. Yeah, exactly 40k. And if we compare it to the custom P4, that hits for 48. And it has 50 more RPM. The mag is of course the same because we can change that. It's exactly the same with the PDR or the named version, the test subject. But the RPM is too low. 50 lower than the custom, and then 8k lower a bullet on the base damage. And that's a lot of difference in weapon damage if you min max your build and all the other boosts are activated on your build. So in my opinion, just like the capacitor, I don't think this is the way to go, or this will be a good gun for the community, because I don't think this will be the go-to gun. I think still other guns will beat it. And yes, of course, the Perfectly In Sync is very nice on this gun. The Perfectly In Sync is one of the best talents in the game right now. Or yeah, In Sync is. So in my opinion, I think that the test shop deck is nice for a few days. And after that, everybody forgot it because all the other guns are way better. Over to the Scalpel. And this is a new Marksman rifle as well. Looks pretty dope. Future Perfection on there, and that could be nice, because at Future Perfection you need to take out somebody to grant you overcharge if you are of course at that 6 skill tier. And it's very nice to handle than a marksman rifle, because a marksman rifle does a lot of damage in one shot. Just headshot an enemy and you will always be guaranteed of that overcharge. Of course, keep in mind, overcharge cooldown is 90 seconds, so every 90 seconds you can overcharge yourself just by one shot. And this scalpel is also, like I mentioned, a new MMR in the game. Let me quickly look at it. It's the Tactical 308. So this is the new marksman rifle added to the game, and then the scalpel is the named variant of it. But yeah, that's pretty much it about the gear and all the named items that will be introduced with TU12. Don't forget, this is the PTS, so hopefully they will change some things, because all the things that I showed you in this video are, in my opinion, underwhelming. They're underperforming, and all of them. Of course, the new brand set can be very nice, especially with the 3-piece giving you that 10% skill efficiency, but the guns, I don't know what to think about that. You know, the new PDR, too low in RPM, too low in magazine size, and too low in base damage. So in my opinion, that needs a big buff. The new Rigger gear set, not that great. For a 4-piece gear set, you're getting 25% skill damage, and you need to do way too much within a battle to get that 25%. So that's way too low in my opinion. Give us that 50% or 60%, and then boosting it up with the chest or backpack talent to that 100 or even 120%, then maybe it's something to work with. But now in my opinion, it's underperforming. And the scalpel, the new Tactical 308, can be nice, but in my opinion, I don't think that the Future Perfection is the way to go. I don't know if it's worth it, especially with the cooldown of 90 seconds and only giving you that overcharge for a few seconds and then switching over again. I think there are a lot better combinations to get your damage out, but you will take out an enemy in one shot because it's an MMR. A lot more base damage on one shot. So this could be something if you want to use that Future Perfection. And the rest, of course, the brand set is very nice, like I explained. But yeah, I would love to see some buffs on all these pieces. But let me know what you think. What you think about the gear set. What you think about the new brand set. And of course, the new guns coming. But for today, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Don't forget to smash that like button and hit that subscribers button. And of course, the notification bell. Pure Prime out.